Mega and my friends St. Anne's High School, Sid Bashirabad, are present here to enact a small skit on untouchability. Kirtana and Atul visited their ancestral village to spend their vacation. Suddenly, Kirtana observed two girls staring at them. She went to them and asked,
"Who are you? Why are you so sad? Come, join us."
Noticing Kirtana speaking to the girl, Sangeet came and told her,
"Kirtana, don't talk to them. My mother will scold."
"Why? Really? Wait, I called my grandma."
Then Kirtana runs to her grandmother.
Once upon a time, there lived a young man who was idealistic and beloved to everyone. One day, he found a poor girl who was an orphan.
"Hi, Chet, why are you crying?"
"Sir, I'm an orphan. I've lost my parents. I'm homeless."
"Don't cry. Come, I'll take you to my home."
Thank you.
half the population was in Fiji. Their mothers were so scared to have a girl child that they themselves sent away their babies never to see them again. It was a time that saw child marriage and confinement of widows as the norm of the day. The society at large was plagued with several social evils. This time, the role was the social reformer to break the shackles of ignorance and drive away the darkness of superstition. It was a time when the country was drowned in narrow-mindedness and unnecessary rituals. An incident, tragic in nature, left an indelible impression on his mind. After the death of his elder brother, his sister-in-law was forced to come in suddenly by immolating herself on her husband's fire. Root out all evil from society forever. He was appalled to see the miserable conditions of men. He realized that it was time for change and founded the Brahma Samaj. He understood that the lack of education and rational thinking were the root causes of all evil. Therefore, he started schools in villages and towns, even as he faced backlash and anger from the sections of society. He was finally successful in abolishing sati in 1851 with the help of Governor General Lord Milton Bentinck. It was a moment of great triumph for this change agent who is rightly called the father of modern India.
or one burn at her husband's fire. You cannot oppress me. You cannot bind me, for I am empowered through education and by the champions who fought for change. I am the new India. I am bold. I am awakened. I have self-respect. I am the pilot conquering the skies, the teacher molding your minds, the engineer giving shape to your dreams, the doctor with a healing touch, the leader leading our generation, the player winning accolades for my country. I am that little flower that simply wishes to fill this world with fragrance, and above all, I am the mother who makes you who you are. All this was possible because we embrace change. Today, we pay our tribute to Raja Ram Mohan Roy, the pioneer of modern India, who is so much ahead of his times. We must learn to embrace change, for change itself is life. Every moment of life calls for change. Certainly, we have come a long way, but we still have a longer way to go. Many promises to keep and miles to go before we sleep and miles to go before we sleep.
वैष्णव जन तो तेने कहिए जे पीड़ पराई जाने रे। वैष्णव जन तो तेने कहिए जे पीड़ पराई जाने रे। पर दुख के उपकार करे तो ये मन अभिमान ना। वैष्णव जन तो तेनी कहिए जे पीड़ पराई जाने रे। सकल लोक मा सुने बंदे निंदा न करे केनी रे। वाच काच मन निश्चल राखे धन धन जननी रे। वैष्णव जन तो तेनी कहिए जे पीड़ पराई जाने रे। वैष्णव जन तो तेनी कहिए जे पीड़ पराई जाने रे।
అతడంటే కడకడ వలికింది ఆ వేల సింహం. क्या हुआ रामी?
अब क्या कहे बापू जी, ये अफसर हमें ये इंडी विंडी के अलावा कुछ भी नहीं उगाने दे रहे हैं।
वरना इस समस्या का हल नहीं है रामू, मैं अफसर से बात करूंगा, परेशान मत हो।
ठीक है बापू।
हेलो गांधी जी, व्हाट ब्रिंग्स यू हियर?
Why are you forcing my farmers to plant only indigo, as it is beneficial for you?
I will talk to my higher officials and we will discuss about it.
The next thing which you need is
Namaste Bhakti ji, hum bahut pareshan hain. Aapko to pata hai ki itne dino se baarish nahi hui hai. Hamare khet mein kuch ug bhi nahi raha hai. हमारे पति जो पूरे खेत में काम करते हैं, थोड़ा बहुत पैसे घर लेके आते हैं और उस पैसे से ये अफसर हमसे शुल्क मांग रहे हैं। हमारे पास घर में खाने के लिए खाना नहीं है, पीने के लिए पानी नहीं है, फिर भी ये अफसर हमसे शुल्क मांग रहे हैं। हम कैसे शुल्क दें? हमारे गांव में इतने जल बीमार हैं, हमें हमारे इलाज के लिए पैसे इकट्ठा कर पा रहे हैं।
परेशान मत करो बेटी, मैं अफसर से बात करूंगा।
गांधी जी, अब आप ही एक हैं जो हमारी मदद कर सकते हैं।
हेलो गांधी।
As a result of Gandhiji's intervention in the Champaran and Kheda Satyagraha, the Britishers reduced the toll tax on the people and provided the provision which allowed the farmers to pay the tax in equal installments and did not make it compulsory to plant only indigo in the farms.
So did you all see how did Gandhiji tackle the British officer? Gandhiji not only concentrated on the welfare of the farmers, but also of the workers. He was involved in the freedom struggle in India. Friends, do all of you know about the Ahmedabad mill strike that took in the year 1980? So, the Ahmedabad, so in the year 1980, the Saurashtra region faced plague. After the end of the plague, the mill owner decided to end the plague bonus. But the mill workers protested on the grounds that a worldwide plague called inflation, which means increase in prices every year, came into existence. But after about 6 to 7 days, the hill workers started returning back to their work, and Gandhiji was left alone. Gandhiji learned the principle of life that common people cannot fight forever. This and then after, Gandhiji followed the principle of struggle through struggle. Gandhiji sat apart unto death, and this created pressure on the mill owners, and they had to pay the demanded 25% of bonus. This was all about the Ahmedabad Dairy Strike. Here also, Gandhiji gave the desired blow.
So, let us all take an oath that we will always welcome Gandhiji by following his principles.
Gandhiji's contribution to Indian struggle taught us the principles of non-violence, peacefulness and self-control. He practiced what he preached. Here is an example from his life. Seen as Sabarmati Ashram.
Children love visiting Gandhiji, a boy who was there one day. Was greatly distressed to see the way Gandhiji was dressed. Such a great man, yet he doesn't even wear a shirt. He wondered, why don't you wear a kurta, Gandhiji?
Where is the money, son? I am very poor. I can't afford a kurta.
My mother still there. She'll make all my clothes. I'll ask her to sew a kurta for you.
How many kurtas can your mother make?
How many do you need? One, two, three. She'll make as many as you want.
But I'm not alone, son. it wouldn't be right for me to be the only one to wear a kurta.
How many do you mean?
I have a very large family, son. I have 40 crore brothers and sisters. Till everyone have a kurta, how can I wear one? Tell me, can your mother make kurtas for all of them?
40 crore brothers and sisters, Gandhiji was right.
After all, the whole nation was Gandhiji's family, and he was the head of the family.
What was the Granthata be to him? From this, we start that Gandhiji was kind, thoughtful, considerate, and had compassion for all.
Gandhiji and Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru lived and worked harmoniously during the struggle for freedom from 1919 to 1947. Though Gandhiji and Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru differed in the fundamental sense, philosophy of life, social and political philosophy, and in shape of social, economic and political structure of Indian polity before independence,
yet Nehru's loyalty to Gandhiji was true and tested, and Gandhiji's love for him was deep and abiding. Now we have Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru's tribute to Gandhiji.
My dear countrymen, my due respect and tribute to Gandhiji. People talk of memorial to the statues of bronze, marbles, pillars, and thus they mock him. What tribute shall be paid in him that would have appreciated? To live and the way to die. And if you have not understood that lesson, it would be better. There is no memorial to him. For the only fit memorial is to follow reverently the path he has shown to us and do our duties in life. Jai Hind!
What a better way to pay tribute to our sovereign nation than this? We hope everyone has enjoyed this show. Next soon, after the show,
thanks everyone for coming to me. This is such a great show. I really learned a lot.
No problem. The biggest lesson to learn from his life is be the change which you want to see in the world.
Guys, don't you think we ought to take a pledge today?
Yes.
Maybe.
Today, on this day, we resolve to purify our mind, our inner and ourselves.
To clean up the environment.
And resolve to recycle the waste.
Not too little.
To heal the earth and bring.
To settle differences by that.
By
peaceful means.
And to adopt non-violence means as a way of life.
Be the change you want to see in the world. Happiness is when what you think, what you say, and what you do in harmony.
Peace is the most powerful weapon of mankind.
Jai Hind.